On the southern coast of Taiwan, a group of recruits are fighting to join one of the Navy's toughest units. The Marine Amphibious Recon, known as the Frogmen. But before they earn this badge of honor, recruits must first endure 10 weeks of training. The climax is with Hell Week. 6 days of non-stop punishment.
滚蛋！私自篡改！胡闹！回家啦！我没有这么烂！
It's a brutal selection course where almost one-third will fail.
各位同志弟兄，有什么没有用？
And only the best will make the cut. Taiwan's Marine Amphibious Recon Unit are trained to approach from the ocean, gather intelligence, and hit the enemy hard.
我们的任务特性就是我们是属于第一线的侦察部队，我们就像是整个部队的第一线的眼睛。They
can operate on sea, air, and land.
专门对从事一些比较高价值的一个战略目标来进行一个攻击。
But their main role is to clear the way for large amphibious assaults.
乘坐的一个载具一般是橡皮艇，都是用利用动力操作，就是外加舷外机，然后再配合你的 GPS 来做海上的导航，来到达你要的一个位置。This
unique unit was born from conflict. As the Chinese Civil War was brought to an end in 1949, the nationalist forces of the Republic of China retreated to Taiwan. A special elite force was needed to keep both Taiwan's shores safe and have the ability to probe into China's coastline. In 1955, the Amphibious Reconnaissance Unit was born. The first batch of 22 frogmen passed the selection and formed Taiwan's first Marine Amphibious Recon Unit.
我是民国44年, 1955年参加第一师两栖侦察连第一期的受训。最主要的，我很喜欢冒险性还有危险性的这种挑战，和普通的兵种不一样。两栖侦察连是第一线的部队，随时 要接受任务。
Modeled after the U.S. Navy SEALs, these soldiers quickly earned the nickname Frogmen. Today, there are only 400 Recon Marines, a small elite corps. Being constantly on call is part of this unit's DNA. To become part of this unit, recruits first have to pass a 10-week selection course designed to test their physical and psychological limits. And it all starts here. Zoing Ken, Kaohsiung, Southern Taiwan. It's already week 9 of the course. 33 men have started and only 15 remain. This class of recruits are already serving soldiers in the Marine Corps.
义务役的弟兄他们受完训之后，在单位服役的时间并不会很久，所以相对的，我们觉得志愿役的士官兵啊，他可以长期的在这个单位服役，所以我们现在都几乎朝向全志愿役的方面来招训。Recruit
Soon Jia Jun has a legacy to follow.
自己的父亲也是以前也是这个专长班出来的，就是其他结束的那时候。
And some just want to be the best of the best.
国军我觉得最有战力的应该就是两栖.
Those that survive will earn the coveted Marines Amphibious Reconnaissance Unit badge.
两栖征收大队备章潜水员的部分表示，我们具备了两栖征收作战的能力。那降落伞的部分是我们具备的空降的作战能力。
It's 6 a.m. call time. Next, they have to pass a swimming test before embarking on Hell Week, the final and hardest week of training. These men have already completed 9 weeks of training, and they are about to begin their final swimming test. First, recruits have to perform a set of warming exercises known as the Frogmen workout.
我们在任务前原本做的蛙操会有26节，我们会取前段10节让他们做暖身、跪卧挺腹、腿部运动，几乎都是强迫拉筋的动作，不自己在水上会抽筋。
In combat, these men could spend hours in water. Their bodies need to be as highly tuned as professional gymnasts, keeping the joints and muscles stretched and flexible.But recruit Xu Changhong's body isn't doing what he wants it to. This is already his second try at the course.
上次受训也是因为受伤、伤势的问题退训。那这次的话，又面临到一样的问题，所以我现在的想法是更坚决。
After the warm up, it's time for a 50-meter swim.But the recruits will have their feet and hands tied.
算是一种逃脱术。对，如果说被俘虏了，手被绑起来，我们会让学生达到可以自己逃脱的一种程度。
The water is 20 degrees.
游泳池水很冰，对，很冰冷，因为这边是地下水抽起来的。
First up is recruit Gao Inchen.And to make things more difficult, they can't touch the bottom.
毕竟如果在渡河或者是在大海里是不可能会有可以让它点地的，所以基本上是尽量不要点地，这是最好的。
这个顶多再吸第二口气，它就不行。打起来。
埋头埋太久了。
其实，在游的那个过程中，因为它只有脚的在运用，所以。我们在有那种感觉，就是会少一份的那种动力。
The cold is beginning to affect the recruits as they start the next challenge. Swimming the same 50 meters underwater without coming up for air.
从事作战的时候，如果有遇到有水的地形，我们可能要进行这个无声的。渗透，或者是要脱逃，就必须要用到平潜。
The recruits will have to hold their breath for about 40 seconds to make it to the end of the pool.
还是太快了。
The recruits are struggling to make it.
哎，你在干什么啊？
有的学生他会求好心切，他平不了，他会硬要去平。那他就会缺氧，在水底下他会直接昏迷，或者是说，水积到肺里面，会造成我们说一个疾病的一个发生。
Next up is Xu Changhong。
只要是关于脚步的动作的话，其实都会影响到那个疼痛。
He takes his last breath and pushes off。Recruit Xu Changhong, this test will be his last. And with it, his dream of becoming a frogman. After 9 weeks training, only 14 men are left, and it's time to really test what these soldiers are made of. The last week is the week they have been dreading. Hell Week. 14 recruits are in their final phase to join Taiwan's elite Marine Amphibious Recon Unit. After 9 weeks of training, these men face their worst fear. Hell Week. 6 days and five nights where they will be forced to undergo continuous exercise. Modeled on the U.S. Navy SEALs training, this week includes a series of 21 separate tests. It's the final challenge that stands between them and their Frogmen badge.
特难周是整个训期的最后一周，也就是说第十周的这个训练。
这个最主要的目的就是希望借由这个恶劣的环境下，学员经过了这六天五夜的训练之后，还能够克服他身心上面的状况。
From now on, they face challenge after challenge. First up, a 25-kilometer run.
We're about 3 hours to complete the 25-kilometer sprint training.
With an injured knee, recruit Leo Taiyu is under the gun.
全部大队都在这里。
With continuous physical exercise, injuries are the main reason for recruits to drop out during Hell Week. And lower limb injuries are the most common. A few kilometers in, and Leo Taiyu can't keep up. His knee joint is hurting, and he has to get in the ambulance. He hasn't finished the run, but instructors let him stay.
还是要撑，已经到克兰州了，还是要继续撑下去，想跟大家一起绝训。
They get 1 hour of rest. And then wake to bad news.
因为刚好遇到三十年来台湾最早遇到的寒流，然后在泼水那一刻很冷，非常冷。
Their next challenge, paddle their rubber dinghies for a distance of 15 kilometers in 2 hours, and then march them back again. Dinghies are the main method of transport used by frogmen. But to move the dinghy in the right direction and propel it through the water takes a lot of effort.
这堂课的技巧就在于团队的合作默契。
Recruits are divided into two teams of seven. Each team has a leader at the back of the dinghy shouting directions. But once offshore, the sea becomes rough. Recruit Lin Yihang is the first to get seasick. But even with one member paddling slower, team number two has better teamwork and manages to stay ahead. They are the first to arrive to the finish line.
要让艇员知道力道拉出来的话，身体自己可以感受到，就是在艇上可以感受到那个力量，就是艇往前的力量。
Now they will have to bring back their rubber dinghies to the camp. Over their head for 15 kilometers. Each of these rubber dinghies weighs more than 250 kilograms. Leadership is key to succeeding.
艇长在这个是领导者的角色，是这艘艇的灵魂人物，领导者控制这艘艇。
The boat is heaviest at the front. The leader needs to keep it balanced, or some recruits could end up carrying double the weight of others. Recruits Sun Xia Jun and Lia Taiyu have leg injuries. The team leader puts them at the back, hoping they will have less weight.
其中有一艇有人受伤或者是不行，扣一分。那一艘艇只要超过五个人，就代表不合格。
The hill is too much for recruit Leo Taiyu. His knee is swollen and in pain. He wants to continue.Recruit Leo Taiyu gets a free ride to camp while the others run the final 2 kilometers. All the recruits have passed the test. But Hell Week is just about to get harder. It's day two of Hell Week, the final week of training for Taiwan's Amphibious Marine Recon Unit. The recruit's next challenge is a 3-hour ocean swim.
这节课的目的主要是在我们要训练学员，他可以在长时间的在海上进行移动，然后在这方面，我们要训练那个学员可以在3个小时内，然后以不离开水面，委员者他都可以持续的在这三小时内游泳。
Safety is important for this test. These men are exhausted and could easily drown at sea. moment. The instructors remain close, and each man has a luminous baton on their head. It's a cold 17 degrees. Recruit Leo Taiyu is suffering more than others.
没有跟课就退训了，他下一堂没有走完，所以他这两堂啊，他只要有在一节没完成，就一定要退训的。
有没有帮忙听？要退就退训嘛。
He has swelling on his knee, and the cold water is increasing his pain.
放弃了吗？
脚没办法踢了，脚痛用手游吗？刘太佑，跟上快点。
He has to rely on his arms to keep his body afloat and finish the exercise.
不能游就上船，可以游就跟上去，就这两条路。要退还不退嘛？讲清楚嘛！
好，退去。先送他去敲钟。
He is the first recruit in Hell Week to ring the bell. This bell is taken to all of the 21 exercises the recruits have to pass for Hell Week. For recruit Leo Taiyu, it's the end of the road. For the 13 remaining, they are one man short for the rest of Hell Week.
一、二，不行啊！二，没有。二。
The first challenge of the day is dinghy training.
上艇，放艇，预备。
Two teams will practice flipping their rubber dinghies. In battle, these men will have to flip them in order to hide from enemy air activity.
敌机凌空就是飞机过去的时候，你可以就是人员不可能在艇上，所以我们人员一定会做防护艇，人员躲在艇子里面。
One member less, team number one is feeling the pressure.
对大家心里一定有影响的，因为大家一直过来这么久了。可是，在这个课程的话，因为退训的时候还是要面对，对自己体能在这个科目很冒信心的。But
team number two is having issues of its own.
有伤有痛就报告。几乎一半以上都脚都受伤了。
The two teams are competing to be first. They first have to paddle it around the harbor. The paddles are collected. Then all the two men jump out and flip the dinghy. Then two from the other side jump on and flip it back. They have to rely on teamwork or they will fail. Even with one recruit less, team number one makes it back to the shore first.
之前都是输，今天蛮开心的。默契没有掌握好了，翻艇覆艇的时候也没有搭配好，对啊，导致就输了。
And those that failed get punished, recon style. Next is a deep diving exercise that strikes fear among all recon recruits.
在徒手作战的时候，比如在海域上有巡逻兵，在你身上也只有一把匕首的时候，你必须潜到他后面的时候，就是需要深潜。These
recruits will have to dive 6 meters and bring back a handful of sand. It's a difficult dive, but one the instructors can monitor.
手抓沙子往上游，往上扒的时候，浮上去之后，第一个动作先比 OK 完毕，再亮出你的沙子，哦，助教才知道说你意识清醒。一、二、三，来，再一、三，踩落好，站起来，然后准备好。
好，再见。
上次做的时候不是做得很顺利，因为做完第一次潜的时候
那个要做排压动作没排好。
解开。
If they do not decompress well today, recruits only risk a headache.But with deeper depths, such an error could cost them their lives.
有些学生会心理紧张，或是排压的时候无法排压，就容易造成昏迷，或是休克。
Recruit Pen Qingche has a fever, and this might threaten even more than just his results.
对，还是觉得头，你现在头在转吗？
学生现在有点感冒，可能会怕那个影响到。
He's been given the all clear.
沙子呢？好。
一刚开始有的时候就发现，这个排压动作无法持续，就马上游快一点，到海底去抓那个沙子，然后再慢慢的上来，然后那个压力就会慢慢的不见。
Their next test is a swim at sea with their rucksacks and rifles for 2 hours.
走过去了。
It simulates the men having to swim ashore from a capsized dinghy.
走。
The two teams have to move together, and leaders have to make sure no one remains behind.
当那个艇长不在的话，他剩下里面可能最资深的可能就要站出来了。发现到我们有人脱队的话，可能就要把我们剩下的团队继续把他带下去。
Those that swim faster remain at the back, while the slower ones are put in the front.
快走，快点！
But recruit Pen Qingche's flu is seriously affecting his speed.
那弱队艇兵他可能是体力已经不支了嘛，然后艇长可能是求好心切，但是说他忘记说他其他团队要去照顾。 不要停下来，继续继续。
With no leader, team number one is slowed down and come in late. Recruit Pen Qingche's mistake gets his team slowed down. They're tired and cold. It's day three, and the night brings a small break for all the recruits.
柯南州也是觉得很累，
蛮想老婆的。对，在这段受训的日子，对，因为都很少讲电话。
Tonight's reflection
下去还不会冷。
Is the calm before the storm.
是。
13 recruits are trying to survive the final 48 hours of Hell Week.If they succeed, they will gain membership to Taiwan's elite Frogmen, the Marine Amphibious Reconnaissance Unit. These next 2 days will be the toughest part of their entire 10 weeks basic training. Next, another swimming test. The bell is carried to each challenge. Recruits who want to quit have to ring the bell to leave.
最难克服的还是这个泳池的水吧。就是一样很冷，而且现在又是晚上。
First, they have to perform basic stretching exercises aimed at preventing cramps when they get into water.
四、五、六、七、八、九、十、
Next, they have to swim for 4 hours using different strokes. This test is not just physical training. In combat, these men might have to swim for hours to reach an objective. The exercise is designed to test their endurance to cold and stress. Just 30 minutes of front crawl swimming, and the oldest recruit, Chen Yuqian, begins to experience the first signs of hypothermia. His low body temperature is causing his muscles to shiver without control. If the temperature goes below 35, he will need to be hospitalized and will fail the course. 当初要来是的决心，你们要决心的决心，不要因为这件事就被打败。The other recruits go on with mask and fin swimming training. But before dawn, there is another casualty.
加油！
Recruit Xiao Qihong's temperature has drastically dropped.
等一下，手先不要动，好不好？
Both recruits are taken off the test. They will have to wait to find out if they have failed the course. The next morning, a run in full battle equipment. For the recruits, there is no rest. From freezing waters to 30 degrees sunshine. 4 days into Hell Week, and the pain is beginning to show.
很疲惫而已，感觉全身空空的，我没办法集中注意力。
Team number two's leader has an injury. His ankle is twisted.
脚受伤，一直撑，没有向医官报告。上面长官在骂说为什么没有一开始受伤就没有讲这样，对，已经拖到好几天这样。He
is taken to the hospital for examination, but this error might compromise him joining the Frogmen. Next, recruits have to endure a 4-hour tactical challenge.
我们等下操作的是困难地形通过。特工人员如果不想与敌接触，他可能会选择一个比较难走、难行走的地方。For
the two recruits who failed the pool test, it's their lucky day. Chen Yuqian and Xiao Qiang are readmitted to the course, even when their bodies are struggling to keep going.
最终就这样，有时候会临时接到任务，所以没事，就是要做好心理准备。
The men must patrol tactically.
他们整个团在这边，一颗手榴弹就全部把你们炸死，好啊！我分配的。营长，是，第二组的人已经超前你们很多了呢。是，今天玩出发呢，你觉得这样好不好啦？好不好？这个指挥通信这方面，其实第二组做优于第一组。 因为在一个开阔地，就像战术动作，其实它没有优劣。但是最主要就是你能不能掌握到你的部队，手势是可以互相去 cover 到对方。When
behind enemy lines, hand signals are used to communicate with each other. Noise could give away their position. Recruits have to make sure their movements go undetected.
卧倒了，30秒给我爬到水晶线。
And the instructors are constantly throwing new challenges to test their mental state.
爬进逃跑，用爬的，站起来干嘛？靠近。
各组各组，我会下一个状况，就是说让他们找什么东西。其实没有这个东西呢，是让他们知道你可以利用这个限地的东西。
Team number two completes the test in 3 hours and gets some rest. But punishment is handed out to those who come in late. It's the fourth night of Hell Week, and once more they will be deprived of sleep.
下一个科目是伪装渗透，主要训练就是他们如何到达我们给他们的指定的目标，然后不要让敌人发现他们。
Recruits will patrol along a trail 7 kilometers long for 4 hours.
因为我们的肤色在晚上看起来会特别的明显，所以把他们涂成黑色的或者是绿色的这样子。
啊，自己就是要注意一下，不要晃神。现在也真的是晚上了，然后现在又很累，真的会很容易晃神。
Recruits are equipped with a radio transmitter through which the leader directs the group. Each team has to split up into smaller groups.
在分组的时候就把它区分为那个七个人嘛，三四嘛，是区分两个组嘛。
Each group covers a different area to make sure the rest of the team can walk through undetected. But the recruits are so exhausted, they start making simple but critical errors.
一个人顾一个路口啊，你这个十字路口那边，他出来的时候谁打，谁要打？那边有人出来要打你们，是谁要打？转下来五十个。
Right now, every error costs them a small physical punishment.
全部五十个混蛋，私自篡改，胡闹。
But in war, these small mistakes could cost them their lives.
喜欢摸鱼，慢慢走。
Last, the recruits are made to crawl on their haunches with 20 kilograms of equipment weighing them down.Recruit Den Qiming is struggling.
不敲钟嘛？
哦，不要。
那你在干嘛？我操！啊！站起来啊！回家好不好？
我不要。
回家啦！
我不要。
烂死了！怎么烂？
With only one day to the end of Hell Week, he might not make the grade.It's the night before the last day of Hell Week, the final week of training to join Taiwan's elite unit, the Marine Amphibious Recon. Recruit Den Qiming has failed the night patrolling test.
回家好不好？
保镖。
回家啦！
保镖。
烂死了！怎么烂？
你在等天使就对了。
保镖。
膝盖就是比较不好，对吧？然后就是。脚方面运动就常不行。
Instructors give him a last chance. He can stay, but he can't fail another exercise, or he will be out of the course. It is the last day of Hell Week. After just 1 hour rest, the instructors have prepared an unexpected wake-up call.Tear gas.
很呛，这个呼吸啊，鼻子都很呛。
The men have to pack immediately.
已经第五天，准备要第六天了。大家很疲倦，能睡觉的时候，大家整个都是完全。很沉的睡着。
我的妈！
But they are too slow, and one recruit bears the brunt.
静姐，都是因为你啊，黄静姐。可是你要忘了多休息就好了。因为八分钟不足的话，我们杨哥就给你休息好不好？
The instructors give out punishment to everyone. Gas masks come in handy for the next test.
调整好你们的防毒面具。
这堂课为基础城镇作战，我是教导队员对于基础的城镇战，以及在做家务搜索的部外围，做那个攻击前进。
The teams have to search through two abandoned buildings and retrieve a hidden item.
每一个房间里面都有一个牌子，然后确实搜索，啊，有找到牌子之后，然后给教官看。
To increase the difficulty, instructors simulate an enemy gas attack.The recruits succeed, and for once, no punishment. It's one day from graduation. On the march back to camp, they get a chance to reflect.
真的能体验到就是无条件的忍耐，无限度的服从，
就是解脱了，然后可以离开，可以结束这样的日子，很高兴。爸爸确定明天一定会来。他会来看看我爬电脑路。
The road to heaven is recon slang for the final test in Hell Week. To earn their badge, they first have to crawl over 50 meters of razor sharp coral rocks.
要让学员在最后一刻体会到说，哎，这个训期已经结束了，他已经可以成为合格的蛙人。
Family and friends are invited to support the recruits. The path has 10 stopping points. At each one, they perform a frogman exercise. It's designed.To make them feel pain.
当然，我们蛙人在执行任务的时候，一定会通过一些很崎岖的路程，不管上山下海。如果他这个都做不到的话，他就没有办法出任务。
加油！加油！助理，
加油！
Recruit Sun Chiachun's father is a Marine Recon veteran. He knows these hardships very well.
爸爸说：“
来
过，
一定要爬完。
行，动作标准一点。
走，
好，走。
蛇形机前进，带上身。
He has come today to witness his son's ultimate pain.
三，三。”我不怕痛，
不要怕，我不怕痛，妈妈在看你呢，
我不怕痛，
加油，
四个八五，
来，你回来，你回来，你回来，你回来，
你回来，你回来，回来，不是我痛了，
是干
什
么？回去，
加油，加油，加油，加油！
To increase their pain, salty water is thrown onto their wounds.
我不痛，我不痛，我不痛。
Team number one's leader, Tsai Chung Hao, is struggling to get to the end. His men are ahead of him. Instructors want him to lead by example.
Chao Zhan. Hen Gun Ban. Go to the next stage.
不要露出膝盖。
He has to rely on his determination to get this badge.
要杀生呢？干什么？
It's one final test to prove they will do anything to join the Frogmen.
我先走了呢。
加油！
小弟，
痛不痛？
不痛。
我不哭。
不哭。
你好棒啊！我们爱你，你好棒。
加油！
For recruit Gao Inxie, this day is even more special.
我很高兴能够成为你老公，你会嫁给我吗？
天堂路通过完成。
就是没有去想多想什么，然后就反正到我的时候，整个脑子真的完全空了，原本想的东西也都忘记了。
恭喜你成为我们陆战花的。
下，下台。
The youngest, Lin Yihang, has won the best recruit prize.
很感动啊！到底能不能挣到这一关，都还自己都还不心里还没有个底。
The men have all made the grade and are now frogmen.
很艰辛，但是还是要挣过。